Hello, here I am with my December TBR already. What craziness is this? I'm gonna start off with the books that I'm actually currently reading because I've been reading quite slowly the past sort of week and a half, so I'm hoping that I will finish these before December, but just in case, I thought that I would mention them. So first of all, I have my audiobook listen, which is Five Dark Fates by Kendara Blake. I should finish this one. In fact, I have to finish this one because I don't have long left on my loan, but I am currently reading it. I have about an hour-ish of listening time left, which equates to about 2 hours of actual content on the audiobook, so I'm finishing that one. I am also currently in the process of reading The Merciful Crow by Margaret Owen. Yes, still I'm on page 144 of 369. So again, I hope that I will finish this in November, but if I don't, then it will carry on into December and will be part of my December TBR. In terms of rereads for December, I am hoping to listen to Our Dark Duet, which is book two in the Monsters of Verity duology by Victoria Schwab, or V.E. Schwab, as is her pen name for her adult novels. I already have that one in from the library. I listened to This Savage Song this month, so I want to continue on with my reread of the duology in December. And I don't have any plans beyond that in terms of rereads, so I will just pick up a reread if I have time based on whatever I fancy. And then I have a couple of book club reads to read in December. So first of all, I have my own book club, which we are reading The Girl Who Drank the Moon by Kelly Barnhill, which is a middle grade book about a girl who has been fed moonlight instead of starlight by a witch, which means that she has magical powers, and so the witch raises her as her own. I'm super looking forward to reading this one. It sounds very whimsical and magical and fun, so I'm really looking forward to it. And then the other book that I'm reading for a book club, which is my local book club, is An Unkindness of Ghosts, which I don't have yet, but I will be picking up at my next book club meeting, which will be next Thursday. It's by Rivers Solomon, and it is a young adult, I think, sci-fi story about a girl living on a spaceship that is ferrying people from Earth to a new colony on another planet, which, by the way, if you didn't know, is a trope that I absolutely love. I love stories about people traveling in groups in spaceships across the gulf of space. I don't know why, but I really enjoy that. So, for example, where is it? Across the Universe by Beth Revis is a similar sort of concept, and I really, really enjoyed this book when I read it several years ago. So it's a trope that I really enjoy, so I'm looking forward to that. And it's also got LGBTQIA+ representation. I'm not actually sure where the representation comes in, but I'm looking forward to it nonetheless. Then I am potentially buddy reading I Was Born for This by Alice Oseman with a friend of mine. Even if I don't end up buddy reading it with her, I will still pick this one up. It is a young adult contemporary novel about, I think it follows two characters. So one character is in a band and dealing with fame culture from the inside, and another character is one of the fans of this band and has struck up some sort of friendship with that other character that's in the band. So it's sort of a look at fandom culture from the inside and from the outside. So I'm really looking forward to reading that one. I also need to finish Song of Sorrow by Melinda Salisbury. This was in my end of the year tag video as a book that I have started this year and still need to finish. And considering it's December coming up, I need to include this on my December TBR, because otherwise I won't finish it before the end of the year. As before, I'm just over halfway through. I'm on page 280 of 452. So I haven't even got 200 pages of this one left. So I need to just get on with it, you know? So there's that one. I have also managed to source an audiobook version through my library of Ash Princess by Laura Sebastian. So I would like to listen to this one. It is also young adult, I believe, and it follows a princess whose queendom has been overthrown and she has to deal with that situation while trying to get her throne back. So incredibly tropey, incredibly generic, but I've heard that it's a really fun read. Elliot Brooks really enjoys this one and I have a very similar reading taste to her, so I have pretty high hopes. And the audiobook narrator sounds really good too, so I'm looking forward to that. I do like listening and reading at the same time. I just find it incredibly immersive as an experience, so I like to do it whenever I can. And maybe that's me becoming a lazy reader, but I don't know, I just really enjoy doing it. So if I can get the book at my library for free, then why not, you know? Another book that I'm actually hoping to read in November, but if I don't get to it in November, then I will read it in December, is Starsight by Brandon Sanderson. I just picked this up today. It came out yesterday. I'm super excited. Yes, it is signed. This is my only Sanderson book that I have that is signed. I don't think he's been to the UK since I discovered him as an author, and I'm just so excited to have a signed copy because he's my favourite author, and I just think it's really, really cool to have a signed version of his book. And if he ever does come to the UK, I will take every single one of my books of his that I have to get him to sign it, because I just will. But I'm very excited to have this copy signed, and I'm very excited to have my hands on this book because I really enjoyed Skyward. I reread it this month, I think, and really enjoyed it on reread just as much as I did on the first read. I listened to the audiobook because I do all my rereads on audio, and that was really great too. I probably will just physically read this and then get the audiobook at some point in the future, just because, I don't know, I kind of want that experience with this one in particular. But I read the first two pages of it this morning when I picked it up, and it doesn't start the way I expected it to at all, and I really didn't want to put it down, but I need to finish The Merciful Crow and Five Dark Fates first. And I actually have another book that I need to read in November because it's for my book club that is meeting next week, so I can't wait to get to this. I'm very excited, and if I can read it in November, then I will, but if not, December is the month, and it will be the first book that I read in December because I'm so excited. This is arguably my most anticipated release for the year, perhaps other than The Toll. I think The Toll and this were fairly evenly anticipated, and I've already read The Toll, so yay. Then we have We Set the Dark on Fire by Tellur K. Mahia, I'm told is now it's how it's actually pronounced, so I apologise for having pronounced this name wrong in previous videos. This one is a book that I picked up at Yalc, and it has a super interesting premise, and I am really, really interested to pick it up, have been for ages, and I don't know, it was just calling to me, so I'm putting it on my TBR for this month. This is set in a world where women go to a specific college to train to be married to a man and become either their wife or the carer of their children, and only people from a certain section of society qualify to go to this school and take on this role. And we follow a character who is attending the school and is doing really well at the school, but she's actually a fraud because she doesn't qualify to get into the school. And then she is given the opportunity to go undercover as a spy, and I don't know, the concept just sounds really, really interesting to me, and I'm excited to read it. And then finally, I have The Starless Sea by Erin Morgenstern, and I'm gonna be honest with you, the only reason I want to read this one is because it's so pretty, but also a colleague of mine from work also picked up a copy of this book and we decided that we would try to read it together. So I think we're probably going to try and do that in the month of December. And it's a bookish book, which I always really enjoy. It follows a character who finds a book in the library, which sparks a mystery, and the mystery leads him into a labyrinth. So there's a lot about the synopsis of this one that intrigues me, because books about books, I love. Mysteries in semi-fantasy stories tend to work better. Mysteries are still a little bit touch and go for me, but if they're in a fantasy setting, there's a good chance I'll enjoy it. I discussed this in on my channel recently, so I will link that video for you. And labyrinths, another trope that I absolutely love. I love a labyrinth. Give me a labyrinth in a story and I will read it. If you know of any stories with labyrinths in them, please let me know. If you know of any stories that involve large groups of people being isolated on a spaceship while it travels across space, please let me know. These are tropes that I really enjoy. Maybe I should do a video about this. Would you be interested in that? Let me know. And that's it for my planned TBR for the month of December. As always, this is very loose. Well, I say as always, this is only my second time ever doing a TBR, but I am quite enjoying doing them. So I think I will continue. And I think a few of you have said to me that you would like me to continue. So I will continue with TBR videos. But as always, it will be very loose. I will deviate if I don't feel like it, because I am a mood reader and forcing myself to read something is one surefire way of me not enjoying that book, which nobody wants that. So I will probably read these. I may swap them out for others. I may read others as well. I actually have quite a lot of time off work over Christmas because I now work in academia, so I am very excited about that. I think I've got about 2.5-3 weeks off, which is just, I haven't had that amount of time off since I was in school myself, so I am super excited to have that much time off, and I'm gonna use it to read all the books. So that's my TBR. That's it for this video. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you like this video and want to see more like this from me, then do think about hitting that subscribe button, and I hope to see you here again soon. Thanks. Bye.